Hey everyone, welcome to this very special episode on Claude. Anthropic has just finally dropped Claude 4.5 and it's now making its way through the entire AI ecosystem. And if you've been part of my insiders mailing list, you would have known that I actually predicted that 4.5 was probably going to land sometime this week. And now it's here. But today's video is not actually about 4.5. It's about this new research preview on something called Imagine with Claude that Anthropic have snuck in. Not many people know what this is actually about, and if you actually read the description, it's not entirely clear. It's something about being able to create programs on the fly. And because this is only available to Max users over the next 5 days, I thought I'll just dive right in and show you its capabilities so that you have an idea of what this is all about. So this is actually a really quick fire video that I just put together so that you can get this information. And if you want to hear about AI related news as soon as it comes out, you might want to join my AI oriented insiders club. It's completely free to join and you can head on over in the link in the description below. As part of this list, I've actually begun sending midweek email updates to give information about what's going on in the world of AI. And I also share a lot of bonus material related to my content that I produce on this channel. If you're interested, click on the link in the description below. And without further ado, let's check out what this whole Imagine with Claude is all about. So here it is, and let's just give it a roll and see what it does. There is like some music that goes on in the background as well, which I'm not sure I'm actually recording. So if it turns out that actually sound and music plays a big role to it, then I will maybe have to re-record this portion again. But let's just see. This looks like some kind of like desktop that we have over here. We've got some stickies, which is interesting.
Right. There's never been a worster.
Okay. And then there's another sticky here. Okay, so I just clicked on this, which actually linked to the weekend video. And then after that, it did this narration over here, which is talking about what I did. Okay. It's showing me the context that we have left. So I'm just trying to figure out whether I can move these stickies, but it doesn't seem that I can. There's the trash bin, which I wonder what it does. Okay, so the trash is empty. And I'm just going to close this. And what about this Claude thing? Looks probably a game, I think. But let's see. Okay, it's like a Flappy Bird helicopter game, chrome dinosaur thingy. All right, so that's cool. Okay, and how do I get out of this? Let's just going to close this now. And then there's Claude code. That's right here. And it's just a link, I presume. So it's a link to Claude code. And they've just done this whole rebrand now. So this is actually new and much nicer looking and spiffier looking for web image. All right, so let's actually jump into what exactly this is going on here, because I still don't know what this is all about. It's giving me a narration of all the actions that have been taken. And I'm just going to refresh this page now because it actually gives you some ideas of what you can actually do. So create a news feed of good news. Imagine this is Shakespeare's desktop and create an email client from 3025. So let's actually just use this one and see what happens. So it's going to create a news feed showing only fictional good news. Okay, so it's actually created like a news feed of good news, which is actually really nice. I used to actually subscribe to this Reddit called Positive News or something like that, which is nice to know. Sometimes it's really nice to have a bit of positive news, especially with everything that's going on in the world news today, which can be quite depressing. Okay, so if you read this, what it actually says here is that it asked me to create a news feed of good news. I created a window with good news stories from recent web search results. And then the contents from today. And great. So actually, this is real. Let's actually say create the feed of everything new related to Claude Sonnet. Sonnet 4.5 and Claude Code 2.0 and see if it's actually going to be able to cover the news about itself. So it seems that it is actually going to be searching. So initially when it posted there, I thought it was going to just use mock data. But now if you actually read the narration, it actually seems that it's actually going to be using real data out there. Okay, yeah. So I think these are actually correct because I actually did see these stats from the other news sources earlier. All right, so we've got this feed over here. And all right, and this is definitely correct. All right, so Claude Code 2.0 definitely has the checkpoints, the VS Code extension, and they definitely have to file refresh the terminal as well. Okay, and this is actually interesting. I think these are some of the news items that came even before Claude 2.0. But yeah, this is actually quite cool. It actually has like industry reception as well. All right, so what else can we do here? So just put this aside. So I wonder, like, after we've done this, whether there's a way to kind of store these sessions, because I've forgotten what were the other options that we had. Okay, let's say, you know, let's say create a game where the Claude, the new Claude mascot, is picking up tokens in the form of Snake. Let's see if this works. You don't know what to expect. It's quite interesting because the whole premise of this is that it's generating things dynamically on the fly. Okay. And let's just take a look. Okay, so there we go. It is actually creating a speak-like game, and you can see that these tokens that are over there actually... All right, so let's see if this works. So it really seems that it's generating like the rules and the game and everything on the fly. All right, since this is a snake game, they probably will use the arrow keys to... Okay. So it actually is doing a bit of reasoning here, trying to make sure that the game actually matches the qualities and characteristics of what you would see in a video game. So you can see here that it's actually reasoning about waiting for the user to press arrow keys. So it's not exactly working. And just trying to figure out this way too. Okay, so this token either didn't really work. It says that it's waiting for the user to press the arrow keys to move, but it's not working. So I guess it's not something that is interactive at the moment, but you can probably see maybe I'm doing this wrong. Okay, so what's the other thing that I can do here? I can't remember what were the other options. So take me to NYC in the 1980s, make a time machine, control panel, and take me to NYC in the 1980s. That's better. So take to London in the whichever century that Sherlock Holmes was around. Let's just see what happens. Okay, so this is very interesting. I'm still trying to figure out what exactly this is doing. That's interesting. So it's created like a visualization, in this case, using HTML and CSS to create the atmosphere. It's created the London buses, and then you can see the reasoning here, right? Using the aesthetic colors and, oh, nice. Okay, so there are all these additional buttons at the bottom. And so I've clicked on that, and you've gotten some additional kind of like information about what it can do. Okay, I see. So during that time, the pop culture was about Blackadder, EastEnders, the young ones, and things from the music scene of that time. This is actually quite interesting. It's almost like a different way to see how the information and data around what the AI knows about it is like visualized. And let's click on major events and see what happens here. Okay, so there was an embassy siege, the royal wedding. All right, this is quite an interesting visualization. Yeah, this seems to be some way of like dynamic operating system that takes the information and data and knowledge of what the AI has, along with probably capabilities of searching the web, and then putting it together in a user interface. So I'm still not quite sure what to make of this, but I thought that I'll just give this a whirl just to see, just let people know, especially if you haven't had time to try this out or you don't have the max plan. At the very least, you can see, you know, how I'm exploring. I didn't prepare for this in any way. I just decided to hit record and thought it would be useful. If there's anything that you would be interested in seeing me do, I'll be happy to try it out. So just let me know. All right.